Good morning, grandkids. It's been a little bit since I've talked on here to you all, and but today I think this is going to be a long one. First of all, I wanted to say something to you about my hair. It is getting so long, and so it makes it look ugly in the back. So I'm going to get it cut just in a couple of days.
Really short.
What I'd really like to do is get it shaved and spiked. I'd like it. My family would get on to me, so I'm not gonna do it. Let's see, I have got a lot of things to show you today because I wanted to go through some young pictures that I have and show them to you. So it's going to take a while, okay? So either you can watch this when you first turn it on if you've got some empty time, but if you're busy, just wait later in the day, click on it. It's always there. So many people say to me, like, oh, they'll say different things. Like, well, because I say good morning or something, they'll say, well, it's not morning here, it's nighttime. Or they'll say, no, it's nighttime. And they don't realize the way they act sometimes. It must be younger kids that this can be seen by anybody who has it all over the world. And so, of course, it's going to be all kinds of different times. And I got this letter from a young man quite some time about, and his name is Alex. Alex, I am so sorry that I have left this lay here on my desk so long. I'm ashamed of myself. But for one thing, I didn't open the envelope for a little while because I thought it was a business envelope. It says his name, Mr. Alex. And then it gives such a weird company name under it that this is all I thought it was an advertisement from someone or a company or something. But it's a sweet letter from Alex. So I'm going to read it to you. And I'm so sorry I'm so late with it. Oh, I'll bet you haven't even been able to hear me because I forgot to pull my mic down. And my voice isn't very loud. All right, Alex. Hi, Grandma. I'm a quarter of a century old. Now, what's that, 25 years old? And I just want to say how much I admire how you're playing the game. See, you can see how long the letter's been laying here because I haven't been playing the game for quite a while. Let me see. I've been a fan of Skyrim since 2011, and I just want to say how much I admire how you're playing the game. It's incredible to see each character has a unique story and journey. Yes, I do like to play the game that way. I play one story with one character, and when I'm through playing that or tired of playing that, I'll make me another character and I'll make up another story. So I'm glad you enjoy that. That's the only way I like to play. My father, Magnus, is in his late 50s and has spent the last 20 years fully immersed in gaming. It's so wonderful to see how much happiness that it brings him. He admires you, and ever since we found your channel in 2019, we've had lots of great conversations about you. I wish I could hear them. be like a fly on the wall and hear everything you say. Although we haven't met in person, I feel as if I know you well. When you've faced health issues, it affects me deeply because I genuinely want you to feel as great as possible. You deserve to enjoy everything that you've achieved so far. Best regards, Alex. That is such a nice letter, and I thank you so much, Alex. And I apologize deeply for letting this go so long. But that is an interesting company name under your name. Sometime if you ever write me again, you can tell me what kind of company that is. Okie doke. This, as I said, I think I said it, is going to be a long video. Well, longer than I'm used to doing. This is a card from it says Kayla Longo. Yeah, Kayla Longo. I hope I'm right about that Longo part. Anyway, the card is so pretty. And she, I think that she did those stencils inside. I'm pretty sure she did. Which I think is very pretty. Hope you're doing well, Grandma Shirley. Miss your videos, but I hope that you're living life to the fullest. Sincerely, Kayla Longo, I guess. I don't know. And she sent me some stickers. I don't know where I'm going to put them, but I might figure that out. This one's my favorite. I wish when I show pictures, it didn't show the screen shininess on it. Anyway, thank you, Kayla. I enjoyed your card. I enjoy those stickers. And there was some other stickers, but I've already don't know what happened to them. Anyway, they weren't as cool as these stickers. Maybe I threw them in the trash. Okay, and here's, I've been digging through a bunch of boxes, trying to get rid of stuff, and trying to consolidate things into as few boxes as possible. Because I know that whenever I'm gone, someday my daughter-in-law will be going through all those and decide what she wants to keep or what she wants to do with it or what she wants to throw away. So I'm trying to make it easier for her. And I came across this card that I got from my son when he was in the service. This was way back in, I think he sent these just after the beginning of 1960. I think that's when he had thought he was going to get out, and they kept him because there was something else going on over there. But one card I kept of his, and I didn't come across it yet, was a he always sends funny cards, but inside there was this little tiny smear, and he printed, "That's a bug," or "I killed this bug." So he had smashed it, and he didn't clean it off. He just left that there and told me what it was, and I thought it was so funny. Well, he did a similar thing with this card. Here's the card, which reads, "I made sure I didn't get you a funny card for your birthday." Oh, yeah. I knew how easily people your age pee their pants. Happy birthday. It says hugs and my son. And sure enough, he did a little funny on there. Look. And he said, "I drew that." He's so funny. I actually, all my sons are funny. I love that. That's why I kept it. Now, What's going to really make this long is I wanted to show you some photographs and that I thought you might enjoy or give you some idea of maybe what I used to do. I used to love to paint pottery. And I don't know what I've done with them all. I have no idea where they're at. Oh, I really dislike that shininess if I tilt it backwards. All right, I painted those three pots. Who knows where they're at? Any of these. I painted this pot. The photograph isn't very good, but it's just got, I just went design crazy all over it. And I would keep turning it around, and so it's painted all the way around, but there's nothing the same anywhere going around it. Like some of this, my that probably went on around behind for a bit, and some other design I mixed in back there with it. So I had fun doing that part. And then these are two others, and I don't put a design on anything. I just like to make my own. So here's another one. And here's another one. I don't know where in the heck they're at. I don't even know where this is that it's sitting on. From the looks of them, I'd like to have them back. Now, these are pictures when I was young. I thought you might have fun looking at them. This first one, I think this is a youngest picture of me and my dad. He is one half Cherokee Indian, which makes me one quarter Cherokee Indian, which I'm happy to be. This is me. This is me in the middle with two friends, one girl on one side, and I think it was her brother on the other side. I look not need. I might still be, I don't know. This is when my sister was still alive. She died at a very young age, with tuberculosis. There. I had an older sister who lived until she was like, I think she was 94 when she passed away. That was my older sister. And then this sister, she was really young, probably not much older looking than she is there when she passed away. This is my skinny, skinny, skinny self. When I was first married, my husband was taking the picture. These aren't very good pictures because they're old pictures with an old camera and not taken very well. This is another picture of me during the same time. And I loved to paint and draw. And I was sitting out in my field somewhere and painting something over to the left, probably a bunch of trees. I've always loved trees. Now I'm always loving dead trees. They're so cool shaped. This is a picture. I was a little older in this picture. This is with my mother. Now, this is when I was really older. And this is when I had my hair dyed red, and I was working in the Salvation Army. This was at Christmas time. This is another picture. I was in my Salvation Army uniform. You can't hardly see it. I had cut that red hair off short. And this is when I was much older with my husband, who passed away in 2015. And we loved, I lived out in California then, and we loved to go to the beach and play with our dogs. And where we always went, up here and back a ways, there was a bunch of trees, and they put a campsite in there. And we could go there and camp, and that's what we was doing at that time. And then this is much older. My hair was still red and short. And this was after I had backslid. And this was me in a bar. Okay. So that's all the pictures that I picked out to show you. I hope you enjoyed this. And I'm going to try to find something cool in Skyrim to do one of those videos I make where the object, like a bush or a rock or something, is talking about things around it. So I might get that done today. I've got an awful lot to do. So I'll try to get it done as soon as possible. So I'll talk to you all later. Hope you enjoyed yourself here. And I'll be back. Bye-bye.